Welcome back, everyone. I'm sorry that I got cut off on that last video. We didn't get a chance to finish up our third type of plate boundary, which is our transform fault boundary. So this is video three for chapter two, plate tectonics. So transform fault boundaries are a situation where the lithospheric plates are sliding past one another. So we are not producing or destroying lithosphere. Most of these faults are found along the sea floor and they offset the mid-ocean ridges. So those divergent plate boundaries that wind through the ocean basins are not this continuous line. They are actually offset by transform faults. We call these fracture zones, and I'll show you an image here briefly. And some transform faults actually do cut through continental crust. A good example is the San Andreas Fault, sits on the continent and is visible at the Earth's surface, so it is the most studied fault system in the world. This is a picture of the Mid-Atlantic Ridge winding through the Atlantic Ocean, so that's your divergent plate boundary. If you see these blue areas, these blue lines, those are the transform faults that offset the spreading center, and this produces this zigzagged appearance. Here is a close-up. So here's your ridge, ridge, and your transform that's offsetting the mid-ocean ridges. This is an image of the San Andreas Fault. So over to the left of the fault is the Pacific Plate, which is moving in a north-northwesterly direction. To the right of the fault is the North American plate that is moving in a south-southeasterly direction. Another example of the transform fault is shown here, and the Mendocino fault is here. So these are transform faults offsetting mid-ocean ridges, divergent plate boundaries. Here is a view of the San Andreas Fault. Here's a sketch we'll look at first. So Wallace Creek winds through, and notice how this is the San Andreas Fault along this section. And this creek has been offset due to the San Andreas Fault. So here's an actual picture down here showing Wallace Creek, and then it follows along the fault here and continues over here. So the plate boundaries are constantly changing. Please keep in mind, though, that the Earth's total surface area remains unchanged. The size and shape of the individual lithospheric plates, however, do change. Plate boundaries migrate, they are created, they are destroyed. 200 million years ago began the breakup of the supercontinent Pangaea. As a result of the breakup of that supercontinent, the Atlantic Ocean basin formed, and also India collided with Asia to form the Himalayas. So let's take a look at these changing plate boundaries over the last 200 million years with the breakup of Pangaea. Here's 200 million years ago and where the continent sat. 150 million years ago, the continents were starting to break up and the North Atlantic Ocean was just beginning to form. Moving to 90 million years ago, the South Atlantic begins to open up as well. 50 million years ago, Southeast Asia ran into Eurasia, and India continued on its march up to Asia. 20 million years ago, India continued its collision with Eurasia, and the Himalayas began to form, as well as the Tibetan Highlands. And then over the last 20 million years, Arabia rifted from Africa, creating the Red Sea in this area. Baja California separated from Mexico to form the Gulf of California. So geologists can use the plate motions today to extrapolate movements of the future. For example, Baja and Southern California will eventually slide past the North American plate. Africa will continue to collide with Eurasia and continue to build the Alps.